To make your anemometer, you'll need 5 small paper cups, 2 straws, a hole punch, a crayon in your favorite color, a pencil with a good eraser, as well as a separate sharpened pencil, and a push pin. First, take one of your paper cups and punch 4 holes just below the rim. Space the holes out equally around the cup so 2 pairs of holes are opposite each other. Next, take your 2 straws and thread them through the holes in the cup so they crisscross, making a plus sign or an X. Flip that cup upside down on a table and poke a hole in the center of the bottom of the cup with your sharpened pencil. We'll set this cup aside for now and move on to the other 4 cups. Choose one of them and use your crayon to draw a picture or pattern. A simple circle is fine, but feel free to be as artistic as you'd like. Draw on the side or bottom of the cup so you can easily tell it apart from the other 3 cups. Next, use your hole punch to punch 2 holes about 1 inch apart in the middle of the side of each of the 4 cups. Be sure not to punch holes through your artwork, though. Now it's time to connect everything together. Grab the first cup you made with the straws in it. Push the end of the straws through the 2 holes in the other 4 cups. This is very important. Make sure all your cups face the same direction. If any of your cups are having a hard time staying put on the straw, you can use a little piece of tape to hold it in place. We're almost done. Take your unsharpened pencil with a good eraser and push the eraser end through the hole you made in the bottom of your center cup. Press your push pin through the 2 straws where they crisscross and secure it lightly in the pencil eraser. Don't push it in all the way or the cups won't be able to spin. You're now ready to measure the wind, so let's test your anemometer to make sure it's working properly. Stand about 1 foot in front of a fan, but stand to the side of the fan so you don't block any wind. Hold your anemometer by the pencil handle and reach it out so it's in front of the fan. Turn the fan on low and make sure your anemometer spins. Remember the drawing you made on one of the cups? You're going to count how many times you see it go by as the anemometer spins. Set a timer to 15 seconds and count the rotations the anemometer makes. To get the number of rotations per minute, multiply the number by 4. Refer to the additional documents for experiment ideas and ways to collect and display data.